The topic is the economic development in Nashville, Tennessee, and of course we have with us the councilman at large for metropolitan government, Mr. Jerry Maynard. And of course, Jerry, let's continue our conversation dealing with some of the problems that we are facing and some of the issues that the metropolitan government, being the council person for the entire city, some of the issues that the whole city is concerned with.
Well, what we have to do, and I appreciate it, Dr. Haney, for this opportunity to be on your show, let's start with education. Economic development starts in pre-K. Mm-hmm. We understand that our students, if they have pre-K, is that they have a better opportunity to not only graduate from high school, but to perform at a level and a standard mm-hmm. higher than what we're performing now. Pre-K works. We have to have full funding for pre-K throughout the entire state of Tennessee. Mm-hmm. Right now, we have pre-K in pockets of Tennessee. Mm-hmm. We need to have pre-K funding, pre-kindergarten funding, for all students to have access to pre-K so that we know that if you do have access to pre-K, mm-hmm. students are going there, they're going to perform better in high school, middle school, and elementary mm-hmm. school. So first of all, economic development starts in pre-K. Mm-hmm. Second, we got to make sure that our schools are not only there with police officers in there to discipline people. Mm-hmm. We got to show that it's an opportunity of hope, of dreams, where you can have your dreams fulfilled, because mm-hmm. education is important, not only for you to get a high school degree, mm-hmm. but rather it will be the key to unlock the door to opportunity mm-hmm. in the global economy. Mm-hmm. We've got to make sure that our schools are better. We got to make sure that our expectation levels are higher. Good. We got to make mm-hmm. sure that we have teachers who truly care about students and their well-being, and we got to make sure that the parents care. Mm-hmm. Education, Doc, starts in the home. Mm-hmm. We got to make sure the parents understand how important education is, mm-hmm. and that even though you're in public school and it's free, mm-hmm. it ain't free. Good. It means that you have to give, mm-hmm. sacrifice. You got to participate. You got to make sure that the parents are participating mm-hmm. and have accountability, mm-hmm. not only from the student, but also the parent of the student, mm-hmm. that they will do the best they can in mm-hmm. education. Our job as elected officials is to make sure they have the resources mm-hmm. and the tools mm-hmm. and the environment by which they can then mm-hmm. teach, not to some test,
okay.
but teach, mm-hmm. right, to the highest level and expectation we can have for our students. Mm-hmm. After mm-hmm. that, we then have to do something that we have not been doing. I believe we have to go back to skills, where we will train those who do not want to go to college, okay. the trades, mm-hmm. plumbing, electrician, mm-hmm. bricklaying, concrete pouring. We need to get back to doing the trade schools for those students who do mm-hmm. not want to go to college. Let's teach them a trade. My brother, who went to electrician, was making way more money than I was as a lawyer mm-hmm. when I began my career, because he was making $30 and $40 an hour as an electrician.
Good.
Mm-hmm. There's good money to be made and a good career, so we have to make sure we teach the trades as well. Then we have to create an economic environment where we have economic opportunities for all, no matter what side of town you live mm-hmm. on. We cannot just do economic development downtown.
All right. We have
to do economic mm-hmm. development in South Nashville, mm-hmm. East Nashville, North Nashville, mm-hmm. and Antioch. Mm-hmm. What do I mean by that? We have to have private investment and public investment mm-hmm. going to and create an environment and jobs so that we can have economic development everywhere mm-hmm. so that everybody has an opportunity. And we haven't seen that. We haven't seen economic investment mm-hmm. in North Nashville and in South Nashville the way we need. So mm-hmm. as a Metro Council person, I'm fighting hard to make sure that we get economic development, mm-hmm. job creation in the areas and pockets of the city that have been ignored.
You know, as a matter of fact, some of the areas that you pass through, there's almost some kind of disconnect
right.
Between that particular area, those areas, and some of the other parts of the city. Is this really a part of the city of Nashville? The question might be raised when you look from one side to the other. There's such a discrepancy. Do you find that as a
problem? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you this. As an entrepreneur, let's say I'm an entrepreneur, mm-hmm. right? Because we understand that jobs are created by two ways. One, mm-hmm. you can have public jobs, mm-hmm. or you can have the private sector jobs. If I'm an entrepreneur, where am I going to take my money? Where am I going to take my investment and invest? Mm-hmm. If I go to a certain area of town that's blighted, mm-hmm. the sidewalks are crumbling, the houses are crumbling, mm-hmm. the utilities are crumbling all around, mm-hmm. I may not take my money to invest because, wow, there's so much dilapidation. Mm-hmm. If I go to an area where the government has made sure that everything is right, mm-hmm. innovative, the latest and the greatest, mm-hmm. then I will take my investment dollars there. A lot of time, private investment will follow public investment. Mm-hmm. We have not had that public investment in areas of North Nashville, mm-hmm. Antioch, and South Nashville that we've had in downtown, mm-hmm. East Nashville, and other areas. Mm-hmm. So what we need to do as a government is create an environment where mm-hmm. private investors will come into an area mm-hmm. to create the jobs, right? that will then create the housing, mm-hmm. create like all of the grocery stores and cleaners mm-hmm. and everything, so you create a community that someone wants to go and live. And mm-hmm. school systems are part of that as well.
Okay.
I'm not going to move to an area mm-hmm. of the city where the school systems are bad. So we got to make sure that the school systems are good all mm-hmm. over the city. That's mm-hmm. how you get economic development all mm-hmm. over the city and the county.
You know, quite recently, I think the one of the unions in Nashville
yep.
complained about the inability for local people to find jobs on one of the largest construction projects that we have in Nashville. Now, what's with that situation?
I mean, that's a great question. Mm-hmm. It's called the Music City Center and is the largest public investment in the history of Davidson County. Mm-hmm. We are building the largest convention center in the state of Tennessee. Mm-hmm. It is $585 million of public investment mm-hmm. into the convention center. And as a council, we voted for it and we said that it would create jobs. The issue and the challenge for us as mm-hmm. elected okay. officials is to make sure those jobs are going to local people. Mm-hmm. We got to make sure that the local residents get the jobs that are there. And so one of the challenges is that if I'm a steel company mm-hmm. and I'm from out of town and I get hired to bring the steel and steel mm-hmm. beams, mm-hmm. a lot of those companies are saying, let me bring my people okay. from out of state with me because okay. they know how to do it. And we got to say, hold up. You need to hire as many local people as possible. Don't bring everybody from out of town, mm-hmm. but rather hire those who are local, who have the ability, the skill, and the capacity to do the job as those persons from out of town. Because it's our money.
All right, it is.
And so we need to make uh-huh. sure that our people, uh-huh. we also have to do something that we've already done. That's create a workforce development. Mm-hmm. Workforce development is part of our Music City Center development, mm-hmm. where we work with the Urban League, where we work with JUMP, we work with other organizations mm-hmm. to say, let's bring in unskilled labor.
All right.
And mm-hmm. let's develop them to get them a skill and a trade so that they then can qualify for a job at the Music City mm-hmm. Center. A lot of applications are being made, but they don't have the skills. Mm-hmm. So the workforce development, which the Black Caucus of the Metropolitan Council, we worked hard with the mayor to get a workforce development system in place mm-hmm. to help train those persons mm-hmm. so they can qualify mm-hmm. for jobs for the Music City
Center. But in the meantime, they have to have the skills in order to train, and so that goes back to education.
That's correct.
And it also gives the city an opportunity to become involved in that kind of training.
That's right, exactly.
Okay.
For persons who may have fallen through the cracks,
okay.
who gets a second chance mm-hmm. through this workforce development mm-hmm. system.
Very good. And of course, we after this second commercial break, we'll have about 10 minutes to come
sure.
back, and we'll give you an opportunity to further elaborate upon some of these things and perhaps say something about the national administration. I know the last time that you were here that
we talked about President Obama.
President Obama,
right? Right.
And I think when I said, well, that's the national administration to me
right.
at this particular time. And so when we come back, we'll, you know, try to get elicit from you, because I know that you are a great supporter.
Right.
And you played a significant role in his early efforts to become president. And of course, we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break.
Can you tell?
About